Soulmate. It had been 5 days since Jane saw Sara. To her knowledge, her friend and roommate hadn't been home in all that time. She was worried and decided to look for Sara at the intersection where Sara had her latest episode, as Sara had mentioned that she thought she would find something there. Whether she would still be there was another question. If she found something, it might have led her somewhere else, or she might have met someone who took her away. But Jane needed to start somewhere. Jane didn't have school on Saturday, making it a good day for her to look for her friend. When she arrived at the intersection, she noticed Sara right away. Sara stood still, her back against a light pole across the street. Jane saw intensity and focus written upon her face, the same look she wore several months ago when she faced down the thugs in the alley. Recalling that moment, Jane thought about the strength in her friend's eyes and the will she possessed. She saw the same determination there again in her friend's countenance. As she watched her friend, Jane got the distinct impression that the scene was not a place where she belonged. She could see Sarah's concentration and realized that talking to her friend or offering to help would only interfere with Sarah's vigil. Sara looked alert and focused and utterly in control. Jane watched Sara with tearful eyes as she realized that although she would do anything for her friend, there was nothing she could do to help. All she could do was watch Sara fight her way through her issues. She hoped with all her heart that Sara could find the answers she was looking for and banish forever the pain she'd endured. Jane took a deep breath and walked away, disappearing into the crowd. At that moment, Sara sensed something, like a light poke at her heart. She turned toward where Jane was standing but missed seeing her by a fraction of a second. Sara knew it was Jane she sensed, and that released a flood of thoughts in her mind. She thought about Jane and how their relationship had deepened over the years, and all the ways Jane helped her. She recalled various moments they spent together, and how Jane was always there for her. Sara wanted to talk to Jane, to hear why she came and perhaps tell her more about what was going on, but could not leave her post. She could not risk missing any chance for another clue. As much as she tried to concentrate on scanning the intersection, Sara couldn't keep her mind from wandering, thinking about the bond that she and Jane had developed. Sara thought that aside from her parents and her master, Jane was the person she would miss most if she was missing from Sarah's life. There was a time, too, when Atos was on that short list. Sara lost many friends over the last 1,000 years, but she didn't care for anyone the way she cared for Jane. With her indefinite, prolonged lifespan, she knew that eventually every person she loved would leave or die. For that reason, among others, she had not allowed herself to become too attached to Pippians. With Jane, however, she couldn't help it. Jane was like a sister. Something felt right when she met Jane, and the longer they lived together, the closer and more bonded she felt to her friend. Jane was the only Pippian who knew any of her secrets, and only the second person, including her master Matsumura, to touch the mark. Even her family had not touched it, though they had seen it. When she allowed Jane to touch the mark, she felt like a small part of her spirit entered Jane, and a small part of Jane entered her. That act further strengthened their bond to something even beyond family. Sara hoped to find a cure for the emptiness within her and live a normal life, to be free and live life as she felt she was meant to live, if only for the short time she feared remained for the world. Sara wished for nothing more than to live as a normal person, Pippian or Draconian, to feel joy and happiness, to live unencumbered and even to grow old. Like Jane, she didn't want her life to be constrained by any means, and her longevity seemed as strong a constraint as aging toward inevitable death, because it meant that she would always lose anyone to whom she became close. She just wanted to live. Saturday, her 6th day of constant surveillance of the corner, waned and drew to a close. Thoughts of Jane gradually left her mind, and she was able to concentrate on all the people, animals, activities, and objects in the area. She felt that it was a person she was looking for, but didn't want to miss any clue. She knew the area perfectly and noticed all the changes in it. The dawn of Sunday morning found her sitting on a windowsill, getting some much-needed rest. The vigil was taking its toll on her. Over the years, she had trained her body to use its special powers so that it required only minimal food and rest, but she had given up her brief trips home to remain on post for days on end. She was growing weary but vowed not to give up. She would stay there as long as it took. As the sun rose, she could see the day was shaping up to be much like that Sunday the prior week. She noted that the sun's glow was different, more powerful. She enjoyed the warmth of the new day and decided to move to the ground where she could be in full sunlight and stretch her body to enjoy it. Not far away, Kendrick made his way, as usual on Sunday mornings, towards the homeless shelter farther along Washington Square. He made his usual stops meeting and greeting vendors and other people on the sidewalk. Sara hoped that her experience of the previous week would be repeated at about the same time, and positioned herself at the exact location where she was the Sunday prior. The hair on the back of her neck and on her arms stood up periodically as she thought about what might happen. She felt in the pit of her stomach that something would happen soon. She opened her senses to scan life forces and absorb auras from as far away as possible. Her heart fluttered and beat more rapidly, telling her that something was near. She knew it was what she had been waiting for. Sara knew she must prepare. The last time, the event happened too quickly for her, the sensation blindsiding her and ruining her chance to study it. That time, she was ready. She knew that when it happened, she had only a brief window to react, even if the feeling that overcame her was too intense for her to make much movement. Whatever was coming, she must be ready for it. Her heart began to race. She sensed something, a strong pull from a clear direction. And it was growing stronger. She had to time things just right. She had only one chance to make her move. Her heart beat rapidly, uncontrollably. Her muscles clenched tight, making it impossible for her to move. Her chest froze, and she could barely breathe. She took a last breath, filling her lungs as full as she could. She held the air in tightly, focusing with all her concentration, her mind sharp as a razor, her eyes sparkling and straining with all their might to spot what was coming through the dense crowds of people. In a flash, Sara saw a particular figure approaching. She knew right away that he was what she was waiting for. The man walked toward her. She saw that his legs were gone from the knees down. Briefly, she felt badly for him, but he had an aura around him that was different from everyone else, and she sensed that his apparent handicap meant little to him. She could tell that he was the one for whom the blood in her veins had always pounded. She looked directly into his eyes, brown and dreamy, then quickly took in the rest of him. Above a formidable brow, his brown hair was cropped in a crew cut that accentuated his demeanor. He had an unusually wide and spectacularly strong figure, with tight muscles. Despite his foreshortened legs, he had a spring in his step and seemed not to have a care in the world, nor any suspicion that his presence was having such a strong effect on Sara. She realized that he could not feel her presence. That is why they missed each other the previous weekend, despite his powerful effect on her. Sara reached her limits, trying to stay focused and was using all her strength to withstand the paralyzing effects of her swelling hope and overwhelming joy. She feared that she might have nothing left with which to face the crash into gloom that could follow her ecstasy again. She hoped that she would not be tested with another crash. She felt as though a mountain of emotion made tangible was pushing down upon her shoulders. Her vision began to blur and her other senses dimmed. She dug deep within herself and pushed out her final breath of air. And with that, she was able to take a small step directly into Kendrick's path, trying to make him notice her. Sara prayed that he saw her, that he did something more than walk quickly around her and keep going, for she could not make any more movement. Her muscles were locked up, tight, and useless. She had only the strength to remain standing in the hope that he would see her. She could do nothing more but wait and let fate align their paths. Kendrick couldn't feel Sara the way that she sensed him. He had no idea that just a short distance in front of him stood the soul of his lost Princess Natalia, bound up in perhaps the only remaining full-blooded Draconian on Earth. He continued walking toward her steadily, an easy smile on his face as he thought about baseball. He couldn't figure out why so many people were in love with the New York Yankees. Perhaps if the rules of their game made any sense to me, he thought, I might understand it, but maybe not even then. In his time, games were oriented toward training for battle or hunting. Even without a memory, he knew that much from the games he played with his elemental spirits. 20 feet in front of him, two soft, glowing eyes drew his attention. He banished thoughts of baseball and gazed upon eyes that seemed to melt straight into his soul. Something stirred in his chest, something he had not felt before. Even in a brief glimpse, something about those eyes seemed familiar, as if he had some strange connection to the person staring at him. As Kendrick approached Sara, he smiled at her without understanding why he was so drawn to her. He did not know what was happening, but the woman pulled him toward her. Having seen each other, Sarah's and Kendrick's eyes were like beacons, flashing one to the other, drawing them nearer, waiting for a splendid collision. People walking by blocked their view of each other, but only briefly. Then the people between them inexplicably parted around their line of sight, and they were able to hold each other's gaze. They were drawn to each other by a force neither of them understood or could resist. With each step Kendrick took, Sara felt more of the nectar of life beaming into her body. She felt a universe forming within her, a feeling so intense she could barely hold herself upright. Energy from deep within her soul welled up, wanting to explode from the depth of her being. The joy, the happiness, all the goodness that life can ever bestow resonated in every fiber of her body. Each second seemed like a happy eternity. Looking into Sarah's eyes, Kendrick glimpsed his past. Like a shell of ice cracking and breaking away, the barriers to his memories fell as her eyes burned through the blockage. Suddenly, he remembered all his past life, including the strange story of how he came to be frozen in the ice so many years earlier. The memories flooded his mind, each as clear as if the events had happened yesterday, the images blossoming all at once, overwhelming him. He remembered Princess Natalia, his true love, his life, his reason to live. A deep sorrow came to him as he remembered the day he left her departing on his quest, and the sadness on her face as he walked away from the warmth of their embrace. Deep inside Sara stirred images and memories that didn't belong to her. Memories of every person who has worn the mark before her flashed through her mind. Sara could see every moment of their lives. She possessed all their memories. She channeled those memories along with the joys and pains associated with them, and saw clearly the original source of the mark and its power. Princess Natalia's soul came out of mourning, welling up into Sarah's mind and becoming one with the woman who had worn the mark for so many arduous years. Sara realized that Princess Natalia's soul had passed to her by bloodline, awaiting Kendrick's return through so many generations, and that, in a way, she was Princess Natalia, in the same way that Princess Natalia always was Sara, and Sara's mother, and so many others. The realization was like opening a door within herself and seeing that there was so much more to her life, her experiences, and her identity than she had ever known or imagined. That beautiful soul had lived through so many lives and endured so much pain, waiting to be united with her love once more. On the streets of New York City, upon the eve of Armageddon, Sara and Princess Natalia, along with the many others who had worn the mark, were all as one. Through the power of love and the magic of Draconia, Princess Natalia's love had endured the test of time.
"Natalia,"
Kendrick murmured in awestruck recognition. He still wasn't sure what was happening, but his face lit with joy. He couldn't believe that there she was. A defining love that was lost to him for so long was standing in his path in a world that suddenly seemed incredibly strange and foreign. In that moment came the payoff for all the struggles he had endured and for his quest to find the Avalon Crystal. In that very moment, his dreams came true. Sara could feel her body again. Her senses were returning. She took a step forward and saw Kendrick right in front of her. They neared each other and extended their hands, their eyes unblinking, glowing for each other. Kendrick saw and understood what had happened. He realized that he possessed cosmic energy, and in an instant, he knew that it had divided itself and passed in part into Princess Natalia on their last night together. That energy survived within the woman standing before him, guiding her, searching for a way back to him. Kendrick was overwhelmed by his good fortune. Within his memories, he realized that he fought and journeyed and struggled so long and so hard just for that day, the happiest moment of his life. He could think of nothing that would bring him more joy than holding Natalia in his arms. Seeing Sara was like a dream that he had thought would never come true. In her eyes, Kendrick saw the hundreds of lives that his Princess Natalia had lived through, longing for his warm embrace in each of them. So much pain and suffering, so many centuries of wondering and wandering she endured just for that moment in time. Kendrick shed a quiet tear as he sensed the millennia of sorrow and suffering endured by Princess Natalia. Despite her burdens, her personification in Sara radiated exuberance. She showed the balance of cosmic forces. Sarah's spirit soared. She had never felt so free in the whole of her life. Everything that she had been through built toward that moment. As their fingertips met, Sara and Kendrick stood frozen like statues, their eyes locked in a soul-sharing gaze. They had found their home, where they belonged, together. Their hearts began beating in the same rhythm. By chance or by miracle, they were together, destined to live as one. Their love had endured for centuries so that they could have a chance at sharing life together. They clasped each other's hands, standing in the middle of the busy sidewalk. They didn't mind the pedestrians bumping into them. They barely felt the occasional push and shove. They held each other, unmoving, not bothered by the chaos of the world around them. It was as if they were the only two people in the world. After their long and mesmerizing gaze into each other's eyes, they each knew the other's heart and soul as if they were their own. They were two people who had become one again. Their two halves newly rejoined. They were whole. Kendrick and Sara wrapped their arms around each other. She felt his big arms around her, his chest against her, and had never felt such warmth and love. Never felt so safe and secure. They held each other tightly, afraid to let go. She rested her cheek on his shoulder, feeling as if she could fall asleep instantly. She felt all the love from her past and all that she could ever imagine. She thought the moment must be a dream, but even dreams don't feel that good or real. She slowly raised her head and moved her lips to meet his. Her cheeks brushed fondly against his, each inch moving closer to his lips in a mile she could not wait to cross. It seemed to take forever. Then their lips met in an explosion of ecstasy so intense they barely contained themselves. She felt a weight lift from her shoulders. She felt like the world was at her back finally, instead of upon it. She knew right away that her curse of the mark had disappeared. Her life was no longer everlasting, but the spell was broken, and she could achieve her dream of a normal life. With Kendrick, she felt alive again. They lowered themselves to the sidewalk at the exact spot where they first held each other's hands. They sat facing each other, legs crossed, holding hands and forcing pedestrians to go around them. They ignored the presence of everyone and everything. All they knew was each other. They smiled and laughed with a kind of laughter that would bring joy to anyone in sorrow. People stared at them, some with strange and mean expressions, but everyone, upon drawing near, was melted by the tenderness of the scene. Once in a while, someone bumped into Sara or Kendrick or nearly stumbled over them, and occasionally someone shouted a distasteful remark, but the moments were soon soothed, and the two lovers didn't notice or care. All that mattered was that they were in each other's presence. The hardships they endured made that moment so much sweeter for them to cherish. They had fought against all odds and journeyed across the earth just to have that day. The love they had for each other was immeasurable. Their primary hopes and dreams had finally come true. Although Sara still knew that the end of the world was near, that knowledge no longer troubled her. She had found the soul she needed to match with hers, and the void within her was filled. Kendrick, too, was fulfilled. He knew his past and realized that the object of his quest had at last been achieved.